Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Crystal Ball SMP. How are you guys doing today? Hope you're doing great. So in today's episode, I plan on making a new little shop, I guess you can kind of call it. But I'll explain my idea as we head over there. So my idea is to make a little newspaper stand. I actually had this idea for a long time, but have not made it, so I plan on making that. Actually, this little area might be good, but I don't want to crowd Lily, so I might just do it down here. But I plan on doing like a little newspaper stand, and its main thing is going to be like probably like bi-weekly news, and then also selling maps of Spawn. And I'm not really sure what else. It's just supposed to be kind of like a little fun thing. Although, I think also I'm going to do some of the memoir sites, or like a, what should I call it? I might call it like the memoir trail or something like that. And it's a book talking about where you can go to see all the memoir sites and what they mean and like all of that stuff. See, like right here. So the Christmas tree is memoir site one. Site two is the Valentine's Day land. St. Patrick's Day will be site three, and so on and so forth. But yeah, so I guess that's kind of my plan for this. I just think it'll be a cute little thing to do. And also give people some reading material if they want to, I don't know, have some cool stuff to read about. But yeah, so that is my plan. I'm gonna do this off camera because I'm not exactly sure how long it will take me to write in all the books and do all of that, because the build is gonna be simple. It's literally just gonna like be a stand, but the books is gonna be the hard part. But yeah, so that is my idea, and wish me luck, because the frog here needs it. Oh my goodness. Alright, I'll see you guys here in a little bit. Alright guys, my shop is finally finished. It's actually been a whole day. It took me a long time to make my shop. It was a lot of writing and a lot of preparation, but it is finally finished and I absolutely love it. One of my favorite builds. But yeah, so I guess I'll go ahead and show you guys the finished product. So if we head right down here, this is the newspaper stand. So I kind of went with a different design. I didn't want it necessarily like a, what I kind of consider like a carnival stand. Like I wanted something that you could actually go into, but still look like a stand. So this is what I came up with. So on the outside, there are seats on that side and this one, just, you know, I don't know, it just kind of looks like you're gonna read something, you know. But the entrance is right here. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and kill this dude because I don't want him coming and attacking us. But this is the entrance, and then once you come inside, there's some beautiful lanterns. It needed some light in here, and I couldn't place torches down anywhere, so these were the perfect thing to use. I think they look really nice. But I am selling three different things here in this shop. The first thing is maps. They're empty, but if people wanted to, they can get a map of Spawn like I have shown here. So for two maps, it's two gold ingots. There's a bunch in there. And then the next thing is the memoir sites. Now, I don't know if you guys have seen these or not, but we have memoir sites kind of scattered throughout Spawn, and I actually wrote more of the books because I think I've written all of them, but I added like five more, which that took a long time. But this book right here goes over all of the memoir sites, kind of explains them and where they're located and that sort of thing. Here, of course, this is a newspaper stand, so I'm selling news books. But these are two gold ingots per book, and I wrote two different books for two different time periods so far. So we have December the 9th through January the 26th, and February the 4th through March 22nd. So people can pay for those, and they have all different sorts of information in them as far as what has happened on the server thus far. So I'll read those off here in just a second. But other than that, I got some little heads, and they're just like little newspaper heads. I thought that it needed a little something extra And since this is a newspaper stand, it needed some newspapers. So there's some little newspapers around, and then people just pay over here, throw payments in the hopper, and that's it. I think that it's a very simple but cute shop. All right, so since the memoir site book is so long, I don't think I'm going to read this one out loud until I'm ready to do that in a future episode. So we'll save that one. But I will read the news books to you guys because I think that they're pretty interesting. So let's go ahead and start with this. I hate that it did this. I didn't know that that was a thing. But apparently for each line of script, you have to do the command where it changes the colors. Didn't know that, now I do, but oh well. So this is December the 9th through January the 26th. So December the 9th, with hours spent on building it, the server spawn was finally finished. December the 11th, the very first crystal cave on the server was found by Brit. December the 18th, the server had an unexpected mishap and it all was corrupted, removing everything that had been built. Luckily, in the matter of a couple days, a backup was able to be used for the server. December the 22nd, in the spirit of Christmas, gifts were given to each member from the server. December 31st, the first shop on the server arrives in the name of Fruity's Spa. January the 1st, Brit's Combat Shop is opening its doors. January 2nd, Lily's Mana and Botania is open to the public. January the 6th, the case of the missing cut down trees at spawn arises. No one knows who cut them down, but everyone knew it was against the rules to do so. January the 7th, Hope's Frozen Bakery opens its doors to the public. January 7th, the Ender Dragon and the first in-city was explored by two brave members, Brit and Hope. They are able to bring back a dragon head and the one and only dragon egg. January the 8th, first cloud pet of the server was found by Hope. January 17th, the brand new server shop opens, selling items that can't be crafted in-game. January 18th, update on missing trees. No one ever came forward, but to prevent more being cut down, a fence was put around spawn, dictating not to cut trees. No more trees have been cut down since. And January the 26th, Secret Valentine opens up to allow every member to randomly get another member and gift them something. So there we go. That was the news from December to January. Okay, here we go. February 4th through March 22nd. February 4th, Brit makes the server's first scavenger hunt starting at the main spawn building. February 6th, the first beacon of the server is put at spawn. February the 6th, the casino is now a new site to see and gamble at. February the 8th, Valentine's Day land is open for everyone to enjoy. February the 8th, the very first fairy horse is brought into this world. February 12th, new rules of mob griefing being turned on and keep inventory being turned off have been added, making this server even more hard. February the 12th, server post office opens its doors for all members. February 13th, the graveyard is built in preparation for upcoming deaths that may occur. February 14th, Brit's potion shop opens its doors for all your potion needs. February 18th, Max's Shack of Pets opens to the public. March 2nd, an advocating session was held with members ranging from Brit, Hope, Lily, ABC, and Mac. The race was a close one, but the winner was Hope. March 2nd, St. Patrick's Day land opens up for builds. March 22nd, a new rule has been added. No one is allowed to be revived, no matter if they have reached their fifth episode or not. Ooh. All right, so that is all the news of the server. I know that was probably a lot, but that's what took so long, was having to write everything down. But I think it's an amazing shop, and it definitely is something cool that people can buy, and they can frame it in their house if they want to. But I don't know. I think that it's a really cool little thing. Gives some history of Crystal Ball. But also, at the end of the book, you heard that there was some new rules added, that no one is allowed to be revived anymore. Doesn't matter if they've reached their 5-episode limit. Does not matter anymore. You cannot be revived. So it's especially scary for some of the newer members, but it's definitely a strategy to make the server even more harder. But yeah, so I think that that's going to be it for this episode. I built this wonderful shop that I'm super happy about. But yeah, so that is going to be the end of this episode, guys. I hope that you did enjoy. If you did, be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe down below. And I'll see you guys all again next time. Goodbye.